Zostavax?
Yes, Zostavax.
Oh, goodness gracious, yes. I said it right. That was the old one. If you had the old one, should you get the new one?
Yes, you should, actually. So the old one has been around since about 2006. Actually, the video we watched was referencing the statistics of that vaccine. And then the newer vaccine, which is called Shingrix, was released last year. It's now available. Actually, it's available at most commercial pharmacies, so that's an easy way to get it. And why it's a preferred vaccine is, in addition to reports that it's got more efficacy in preventing shingles, as well as the long-term pain syndrome, post-herpetic neuralgia that is associated with the shingles disease, is that it's actually not a live vaccine. So referencing back to the different types of vaccines that we talked about earlier in the segment, the Zostavax is a live vaccine, and so it was only certain populations that could get that vaccine and certain populations could not. And now with the new vaccine, Shingrix, which is a inactivated vaccine, we're able to vaccinate a broader population and protect more people from developing shingles.
So this is not one that if you get it, you'd be fearful of it just happening.
Correct. So this, the Shingrix vaccine is not a live vaccine, so that's a good thing.
And also,
it is recommended that even if you did complete the previous vaccine of Zostavax, that you do get the Shingrix vaccine because it is a different vaccine and it's supposed to be more efficacious.
Is it just one shot? Because I don't like needles.
So it's actually two vaccines. It's a two-dose series.
Oh my gosh.
Sorry. And the second dose can be given anywhere from 2 months to 6 months from the first dose.
Where is it given, just out of curiosity?
Usually in the arm.
The arm?
Yeah,
okay.
Usually in the arm.
I'm such a chicken when it comes to needles. Does the risk of getting shingles increase with age?
It does. Oh. So unfortunately, it does increase with age. That has a lot to do with, as we mentioned, that as we get older, our bodies change, our lifestyle changes. We have certain medical conditions that develop over time. And that, as we all already know, we get very busy and stress. So these things are all ways that can result in the development of shingles.